Alright you guys, I got
this case averaging 4.9, but that's not correct because case 1 is sensing -8, -9, and we got case 3 at 2.59, so the average of these gets us a 5.0, so therefore the EPR valve is going at 100% for the entire A14 12-door circuit, but like 8 or 9 or 7 of those doors are already too cold, and one of the cases giving us trouble. Got that one going down, and then we also got this case, A07, set point 34, but it's too cold. Why is it too cold? Go to the circuit. We see that the EPR valve's at 0%, so it should be closed, not working, getting too cold. We got juice in there. Look at the alarms. We got alarms for A07, A14, 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 A14. And that's right there, the only place we're going to concern ourselves with. So we've got case high temp, case low temp. A14, case 3, A14 underscore 3. This one. So let's go check it out. So here's my A07 case. You see it's got juices, and yet way too cold. Got the milk, well, at least up here. Oh, that stuff is freezing. Look, it's freezing. It's already, yeah, see, that's how you know it's expanded right there. Here's my A14 aisle. This is case 3. Case 3 on all four doors has no airflow. Those are good. Let them air out a little bit. Warm up. I'm gonna get some. I gotta get a cart and empty the bottom shelf. Sonic fries. And of course we could call it, it's froze up. No air can get through it. But this ain't the first time it's happened. Man, or the guy says, I don't know if he's a manager or not. The guy says that they have to keep emptying it so that it can be washed or whatever. Let's put it in defrost and see what it does. Also gonna put this one in defrost because it's too cold. Hot gas defrost. You can see we got some hot gas going in here now. We're gonna watch the duration and we're gonna watch the sequence of operation. Defrost vapor enters evaporator causing a rise in temperature. At about 35 degrees, the control relay thermostat closes the fan relay coil and control relay coil circuit. The coil opens the fan, door heater and frame heater circuits while energizing the drain pan heater. So while troubleshooting, I unplugged these three fans and I left the fourth one running, and as I was reading that to you, the clicks on over here activated or deactivated, whatever, and shut the fans off like it's supposed to do. So we've got some melt occurring. It's important to make sure this is working. If your fans stay on during defrost, it won't defrost the evaporator. Ooh, look. That's a plugged drain. Now back to my AO7 case. It's warming up too much, so I'm gonna take this one out of defrost. Alright. So you got end manual mode. And then it'll start back up. Now I've got another work order for this one, so I'll have to focus on this more after I get the low temperature one going. Now, back in here, A14, I want to know more about it. I want to know how long defrostration, 25 minutes, that's not going to do it. That's not going to defrost this one. Don't know why. So it goes off one time a day. We have one defrost every 24 hours. Right there at 8:30 p.m. And it's 25 minutes long. Let's look at another one. 25 minutes long, only one defrost. So that's right. Apparently that defrost is capable of defrosting an entire coil. Reasonable amount of time. So we gotta find out why that left coil isn't defrosting. I don't like this. Receiver liquid level long term. Looks like it's low on refrigerant guards. So this is long term. This shows over the course of months. See, this case is hovering behind from termination temperature, not reaching termination temperature. Maybe because it's full of ice. And now it has just came out of defrost because it went back into drip. Liquid level's gone up to 4. I'm going to cycle it through another defrost. See, my AO7 is freaking getting cold. Something's up here. This EPR is closed, but it's still feeding and overcooling. Alright, so I'm into my second defrost. It's about to kick out of defrost. It's been almost 25 minutes already, and it's melting good. I got a wall of ice behind the evaporator, though. You see, something's gonna have to happen with that. And these are evac system type of drains, vacuum drains. They don't drain into the floor, they drain out from above. So I can't really use hot water. Alright, so I'm going on my third defrost on A14. Now, because I don't have floor drains, I got vacuum drains up there. I am manually turning the fans on and off every few seconds, monitoring the temperature in the evaporator back there, on the top right there. And so I am toggling it. It's much easier when I don't have to hold a camera. So when I activate the fans by pulling the wire, you see I get some water. Starts to flow. So I wasted probably at least a good hour with this air defrost, and it really didn't get me nowhere. I learned that the hard way today. Alright, so what this ended up turning into is hauling hot water with a pump-up sprayer to melt all of ice right here. I've got a lot of it, but I still got a lot to go.
4 is done. And I got... Oh, 3 doors done. Or something like that. I'm almost done.
You know, with your pump-up sprayer, you can just, you know, push it up against the wall. And you can kind of, you know, aim it. Point it like that. Pretty easy. Means your hose has come loose from your straw or whatever. Thank you.
All right, this is the last one. fans are on, and I got airflow because I got no more wall of ice blocking air in the back.